In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this bounce spline render scene in 5 minutes. After selecting the default cube, type G, Z, and 1 to align its bottom with the world center. Let's create a plane, and S to scale. After selecting the default cube, let's add the bounce spline. If you don't see that in the menu, please activate extra objects add-on. Bounce spline creates a continuous knot around a target mesh like this, and we can bevel and extrude from its properties window. The knot looks like this, and it can be used to create great-looking coil meshes and more. Let's customize the knot. Please feel free to experiment with the settings, and use the one that will give you the best result. I have used the default cube as an example, but this knot can be applied to any meshes we create or import to create great-looking scenes. I'll go with this pattern. Do you remember how I have moved the cube to align its bottom face with the world center? The current knot's Z position will be closer to the world center that way, so we can render the scene like this. Or we can align the mesh any way we like. Let's set up the render scene and apply the materials. Select the main node, and press Ctrl, Shift, and T together to add the PBR texture images. To use the Ctrl, Shift, T feature, we need to activate an add-on called the Node Wrangler. I'll share the download link in the description below. For the knot mesh, let's add the usual gradient color ramp nodes. Select this gradient node, and press Ctrl, T, together. To use the Ctrl plus T feature, we need to activate an add-on called the Node Wrangler as well. I'll go with the UV node, but please feel free to experiment with other nodes. I'll use the sky texture. Let's turn off Use Nodes under Compositing. I'll also use 32 samples to render. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.